MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 5 of the National League Division Series between the San Diego Padres and the Chicago Cubs. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjan. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, this is still anyone's series here as we get ready for Game 5.
And guys, I'm going to be sorry to see this series come to an end. You've got to love a series that comes down to the final game. And seeing the push and pull struggle between these two teams over the last four games has been a lot of fun. We're in for a great one here in Game 5.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Kyle Hendricks gets the call in Game 5 in front of the hometown faithful. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, with a guy like him, you're just looking for quality innings. Usually he'll give you six or seven, and he keeps the team in the ballgame. And when you think about it, what else do you really want from your starter? He's capable of shutting a team down and dominating, but that's not what's expected of him all the time.
And the hit will be Trent Grisham. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And it'll be important to stay warm tonight. A chilly 44 degrees here at first pitch. A 1-2.
Outside, that's a ball.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Fernando Tatis Jr. is on deck. Line toward center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. One batter in, and the Cubs are going to have to handle a threat to run on the base paths.
I know in today's game everybody's trying to go yard, but can you look at having a better at bat? As a leadoff hitter, you take it full count, you make the pitcher work, and then you come through with a knock. Great start.
Standing in now, Fernando Tatis Jr. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. And that'll get through into left. Back-to-back hits here to open our ballgame tonight.
Hey, they're seeing well right now. They were obviously paying attention in the hitters meeting. He's found a barrel to the first two guys to start this game. Now he's got to worry about the middle of the order.
In now, Manny Machado fouled off. Working for the punch out and the offering. Swinging a blooper to the right side. Corners got it for the first down.
That was good. The first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
Eric Hosmer to the plate now. Up numbers with Hendricks, just a 3-for-13 batting line. He's taken him deep once. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. First and second now, one man out. around towards short. One there. And to Rizzo, and it's a double play. Side retired. So a couple of hits here in the top half, but nothing comes of it. Now the Cubbies will get their first crack. No score. Blake Snell has the ball for the fifth game of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
You know, the key for Blake Snell is getting him out on that mound every 5 days. He's had some injuries over the course of his career, but there's no doubting the stuff. He's another guy, upper 90s fastball, good curveball. His slider's gotten a lot better, and he'll mix in an occasional changeup. This guy has a chance to be a dynamic pitcher every time he takes the mound.
And stepping in, Ian Happ. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Happ with a 2-1 count now. The 2-1. Will not catch the zone. Ball three. Waiting next is Anthony Rizzo. Fastball in there. 3-2. And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Batting second, the first baseman, Anthony.
So in now for Chicago, Anthony Rizzo. From the belt, kicks and deals. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
At the plate, Chris Bryant. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now. He's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
Back up the middle. And that gets through for a one-out base hit.
You don't see that too much in today's game. Most guys, it doesn't matter what the count is. They're looking to line them, drive the ball out of the ballpark. Not the case here. Good two-strike adjustment, able to punch a ground ball through a hole for a single.
So now to the plate, Wilson Contreras hit the other way out toward right field. Myers is over just a few steps to his left as he takes it for out number two.
That is it. No good pass. Javier Baez.
Here's Javier Baez. Two men are on with two men out. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. From the stretch, the 1-2. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Here's the 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Ready with the payoff pitch, and it's fouled away. He set the payoff pitch, fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Hammered the other way to deep right field. Myers going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Cubs strand a couple. We are still scoreless. Pham, his matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's 4-for-14. He also has one home run. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Oh, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Late now is Will Myers. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. No score here as we play inning number two. Sent on the ground out to second. Reined in. Throw gets him. Two down. And with two away, look at our playoff tree here. And our winner here gets set to take on the LA Dodgers in the NLCS. And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. Bases are empty here with two men out. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Throw to first, beats him easily, and the side is retired. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. And we are tied 0-0. Last half of the second set to go, and in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson. The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. Ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Blake now, Nico Horner. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Cronenworth ranging into the outfield. He gets there, and that's the second out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Stepping in now, Jason Hayward. And that one yanked just foul. Bottom of the second here with no score. Counts even to Hayward, two balls and two strikes.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Popped up, Cronenworth trying to get there. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. We'll move to the third with no score. Now to bat, Austin Nova, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Two picks. Swung on and hammered. No doubt about this one. Watch it fly. And And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. So a solo shot down the line in left, and the Padres bust out in front 1-0.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup, so a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
Into the box now, Blake Snell. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that brings up Trent Grisham. Bases are empty, one man out. Lifted down the line in left. Coming in is Peterson. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. He singled in his first AB. Now one hit fouled over to the right side as the count moves to 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. The Padres get one in the inning, and it comes on the solo home run. Bottom of the third coming up. It's 1-0 San Diego. Bottom of the third now, and the pitcher Kyle Hendricks will be the next to bat. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. In for strike two.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
And this will be no problem over at third, and there's the first out. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 1-1 home.
Nope.
One out, nobody on. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. Throw on to first, two gone.
Up next is
the next hub up, Anthony Rizzo. 0-1 here in the early going.
Rizzo.
One-one. Waves and misses for strike number two.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitches second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Payoff pitch home. Popped him up.
Nola
is under it. And that will end the inning. Cubs are down in order. They're down 1-0. Manny Machado flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
1-1. Fouled off.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but he's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another 1-2 delivery.
Yeah, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed strike three.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
To the plate now, Eric Hosmer. Good idea with the change, but it's 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
High and deep down the left field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. One run on three hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. And another foul ball. Here's another 2-2. Now a swinging bunt.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
And it's fouled away. Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Certainly not showing any signs of intimidation with these middle of the order guys. That's back-to-back K's, and the 3 and 4 guys are harmlessly back in the dugout.
Standing in now, Tommy Pham. And it's a 3-2 count.
Boy, he looks strong up there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side in order and against the middle of the order, too.
Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Hit on the ground out to short. And oh, the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. Reach it first.
Man, there's just no excuse infielder to make a play like that, especially your shortstop. Looked like a routine play, but for some reason, he just pulled the first baseman off the bag. It happens, but you never want to give a team extra outs.
Now a throw over to first. And a dive, but he's back in there. Into the box, Will Myers. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Padres lead one, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up Chris Bryant. The 2-1. He swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Wilson Contreras. Flew out in his only at bat so far. The 1-1.
No, that's down.
No runs, just one hit, one error for the Cubs to this point. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. 2-2.
We got a full count.
Javier Baez waits on deck. The 3-2 pitch. Swung on and got him on strikes.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
So now to the plate, Javier Baez. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. 1-2.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now, I'm not throwing anything near the strike.
We'll have to press pause as that's strike three to retire the side. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They still trail 1-0. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up Jake Cronenworth. Here now the 2-2. Looked at and the count moves full. Austin Nola will be next. Chopped on the ground over to first. And he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted. That'll bring up Austin Nola.
Yeah, and he wasn't fooled at all by the changeup last time. Kept his hands back and absolutely destroyed that ball. So I got to think he's not going to see a changeup in this scenario right here.
1-2 now. It's a 2-2 count to the Padres catcher. Still 2-2. Softly hit toward the hole. On to first, and there were two down. Up next, it'll be the pitcher for the Padres, Blake Snell. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2. Tapped up the first baseline. It's a foul ball. Two out, nobody on. 2-2 now with two away and the base is empty.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
For the first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Padres down in order, but they're on top 1-0. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Looks like double-barreled action now in the San Diego bullpen as they get a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, he's really on a roll in the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side. And now picks up right where he left off by off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
Stepping in now, Nico Horner. All even now, 2-2.
Wow, that's four straight Ks. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Myers. But he won't get there. It falls in. Only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, man, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Into the box now, Jason Hayward. Popped him up. There to pull it in is Machado, and that's out number two. So here now, pitcher Kyle Hendricks hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
1-1. Hit on the ground to third. Machado was there. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. One left for the Cubs. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Sixth about to get started, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Trent Grisham. Hit on the ground out to short. Baez fields it from deep in the hole. On to first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag.
So frustrating, Nero. You make a good pitch, and you get these guys that can run around and they're fast. You think you have an out, all of a sudden it turns into an infield single.
Yeah, this is definitely part of his game, the ground attack, Dan. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles, and he knows how frustrated that pitcher is.
And the 3-1. Hits this one hard the other way. That's through for a base hit, his second of the ball game. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Boy, that's one of the, I guess, the advantages of hitting with that hole between first and second base, D-Row. First baseman has to hold that runner on. That leaves that right side wide open.
Yeah, and credit the batter right there. Nice piece of hitting right there. Not trying to do too much. He took a look at the defense and saw where it was aligned and tried to beat it.
To the plate now, Manny Machado. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Long throw to the plate. But this won't be in time as he's well saved from the run scores. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll help to settle his guy down. Here comes the Chicago skipper now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. He'll wind up lasting just 5 innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Ryan Tepera takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the 6th inning.
The Chicago Cubs, number 52, Ryan Tepera.
Standing in now, Eric Hosmer. And he popped him up. Coming in is Peterson. But he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. Hack on another here as the runner scores from second.
Hey, with that base hit right now, the lead's 3-0. And the way their pitcher's going, D-Ro, that might hold up in this one.
Yeah, and you're well aware of it, Dan, as an offense, just trying to put those extra runs across the board. You can take a look at the guy on the slab, toeing the slab. He's on fire right now.
At the plate, Tommy Pham. Into the corner and slicing foul. Lifted in the air to center. Pham is right there, one down. Next to the plate for the Padres. Myers, he went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
A 1-2 count to Will Myers. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Up next, Jake Cronenworth. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Hey, this is a big pitch right here. Can't allow them to attack on any more runs. Let's see if he attacks his own or buries something in the dirt.
So two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. Fouled away. And he sends it out of play. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. So it's two runs on four base hits. No errors and a couple of men left on. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Padres 3 and the Cubs nothing. Bottom of the sixth inning now. And standing in the outfielder, Ian Happ.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound. And these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
At the plate now, Anthony Rizzo. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw in time at first for out number two. Two away now for the Cubs in the sixth. And into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a little tapper. Two-two. Swing and a shot toward right center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Cubs are down in order. They trail in this one 3-0. Chafin is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 39, Andrew.
So now to the plate, Austin Nova comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Here's the 1-1. A ball and two strikes now. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Here he comes again, 1-2. Now this is on the ground for Baez. It's short. Oh, and it sailed right over his head at first.
Yeah, and when the ball left the bat, you figured it was a routine out, but that's how quickly things can change. As it stands, there's a runner on second base and a base hit away from coming home.
So now to the plate, Snell. And he'll try and get his man to third here as he puts this one down. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Well, when you're trying to move a guy up to third with a bunt, that's exactly how you want to do it. Make the third baseman field the ball. That way his only play is to first. That was very well executed.
Now Trent Grisham. Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low. A swinging bunt out in front of the plate, and that's the second out. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. Two outs here with a runner at third. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. Hayward is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. One left for San Diego. They lead it 3-0. Keone Kella gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 27, Keone Kella.
Bottom of the inning now, and next to hit is the catcher, Wilson Contreras. Up Javi Baez. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one.
Baez.
The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two. And he fouls this one off. Here now the 2-2.
We got 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball. Three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
Into the box, Jock Peterson. Hit hard, but right into the shift. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Three up, three down for the Cubs. Still down 3-0. Brendan Workman has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 45. Redhead.
Now into the box, Manny Machado delivered an RBI single last time up. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The 3-1 pitch is in there for a full count now, 3-2. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out. So one man gone for the Friars in their half of the eighth. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. One out, nobody on. 1-2. That looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
That has to make you feel really good as a pitcher, right? You're making pitches all around the zone, and then you bring that one inside. You can't do anything with it. What does it do? It just locks you up inside. You have no chance to put the ball in play.
Stepping in now, Tommy Pham. 3-1 to the Padres left fielder. The count will be full. 3-2 pitch. There's a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Three up, three down, San Diego. But they're on top by a count of 3-0. William Pagan is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 14.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the second baseman, Nico Hoerner. Here's the 3-1, and this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eight.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And that'll bring up the multi-gold lover, Jason Hayward. Good take there to lay off the high fastball.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in the zone to induce a ground ball double play.
Nobody out, runner on first. Left side. Look at Machado. The throw to second for one.
You can make the argument Manny's the best third baseman defensively in the game. He's certainly the smoothest. Absolute rocket attached to his right arm right there. That diving stop was gorgeous.
Cameron Maven will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 15. Cameron.
Runner at first here, one man out.
Nope,
and this one's low here, so the count's 3-1.
Well, tying run on deck. He should get something really good to hit right here in a 3-1 count. I'd be sitting on a fastball middle end.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. A bouncer up the middle. He'll go to the bag for one. On the first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. So nothing happening this time. The fifth and final game moves to the ninth inning now. It's the Padres 3 and the Cubs nothing. Kyle Ryan enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. So here is Will Myers, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Fouled off. The 1-2 pitch.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
The 2-2 one more time.
Full count. 3-2.
We've got ourselves an awesome battle going on right here. Bottom line, the guy who's going to win this situation is the guy who executes.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Back up the middle. A dive, and he knocks it down. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, dealer in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
In now, Jake Cronenworth. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Now a move over to first, and the runner back in standing. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. There's one, but no real shot at two as he's safe easily at first. Austin Nola stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Runners on first with one down. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down. Jurickson Profar will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. And he takes a called strike two.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive it a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. A runner on first with two away. Pops this one up. And Rizzo able to make the catch, and the inning is over. Padres lead one, but they lead it 3-0. Pomeranz comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 15, Drew Pomeranz.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
The 3-1 pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Myers going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Now back. First baseman.
Now at the plate is Anthony Rizzo. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Good discipline to lay off there, and it's 3-1.
Tough spot in the game right here. You have a very close call that doesn't go your way. This is when you have to really regroup as a pitcher and go out there and try to make quality pitches.
Popped him up.
Machado
in foul ground, two gone. It is Chris Bryant, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Pitch. He takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Two out, nobody on. Bryant looking at a 3-1 count.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Oh, now here's a drive out to the alley. Bryant around first, heading for second. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Man, I don't think he could have bisected those fielders any better if he tried. Drove that one into the alley for a gapper that'll bring him easily into second base.
Now, Wilson Contreras can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
He struck him out, and that'll do it as they've won this series, so they'll move on.
Well, my advice to them is to enjoy this moment, celebrate with teammates, and then realize that none of it will matter if they don't get back to work in the NLCS. They've wet their beaks with this postseason success. Now they want some more.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our hardworking crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been the National League Division Series.
The final line score for our ball game.